15 matches over 2 hours, and only two of them featured the women. Fucking hell. I'm John Retham with my review of AEW Dark, and Excalibur Taz and Anthony Ogogo on commentary. Let me know what you guys think. They got split between Tuesdays and Fridays. This is getting ridiculous. Too many squash matches on one single show. Fucking hell. WWE does way too many programs as well. You need to limit it, otherwise you're going to burn out your audience, especially asking them to watch this 2+ hours of squash matches, maybe one competitive match, and then Dynamite the next day. Bishop King versus Darby Allin. Bishop King has a good look. Darby with some impressive dives. Don't know why he wishes to leave this mortal realm so soon. And then gets the Last Supper pin. 1, 2, 3. Layla Hirsch and Elena Black teamed up. Got to see them on Shimmer at the Collective, which was actually a pretty good show overall. And Layla Hirsch also had a good match with Serena Deeb on Dynamite. And Elena Black is quite good. Has a good look. Versus Red Velvet and Cody's Nepotism Project, a.k.a. Brandi Rhodes. Brandi Rhodes said that Red Velvet reminds her of her action figure, Little Bran-Bran. Stop trying to make Little Bran-Bran happen, Brandi. It's not going to happen. Just like your wrestling career isn't going to fucking happen. At least not a good wrestling career. 3 out of 4 are good. Hirsch is quite good as well. And naturally, they couldn't give the pin to Red Velvet. They had to give it to Cody's Nepotism Project. And Elena Black got pinned but with a pump kick. 1, 2, 3. Brandy's fucking rotten. You can check out what I said last week and see how much, you know, I just absolutely can't stand her on TV. She's fucking rotten. Don't want the racism or thrown at her. Let's not do that. Let's not throw it at the person, but we can throw it at the goddamn character. We can throw all our criticism, except racism, at the character. Because the character is fucking rotten. So, Jurassic Express with the twerp versus Danny Limelight and Casey Navarro. Danny has a bright future. There's an awkward press where Luchasaurus just kind of threw him into the ropes. Was supposed to throw him through the ropes. Don't know why the fuck he did that. Pop-up card to KC. And then powerbomb variation. 1, 2, 3. Danny Limelight gets pinned. And Jungle Boy, I think, really is going to be goddamn good. Him and Luchasaurus are a good team. Because Jungle Boy is going to be a big breakout single star. Inner Circle opens up the briefcase. And it's a little bit of the bubbly plug. Drink it and you can be just like Chris Jericho and you can support Donald Trump and you can be a goddamn brainless idiot. And I don't care if anybody wants to get offended because Chris Jericho's a brainless goddamn idiot. You know, that has been horribly out of shape for the last number of years. And he apparently just loves to party and he loves to support Donald Trump. And so is The Undertaker. So I'd like to take this opportunity to say as good as they were in their careers, as great as they were in their careers, fuck them as people. They're fucking idiots. So, Ryzen versus Kazarian. This is the best Ryzen has looked, is what I wrote. And actually, he had a pretty good, you know, pretty good series of shots here. And then reverse DDT, 1, 2, 3. So Kazarian gets the victory. Of course he was going to get the victory. He had to. And then Dasha goes to interview him. Jack Evans and Helico attack Kazarian because they had faced off against, they faced off against SCU. Either, was it on Dark or Dynamite? I actually forgot. I think it was Dark. I actually forgot. Daniels then evens the odds and hits the Angel's Wings on Evans. And then we get Dave Dutra, who looked like he was out of an Italian medieval movie. And you know the kind I'm talking about, like the 80s ones. Versus Ricky Starks. Pretty much Rochambeau for 3. It wasn't bad. I wouldn't mind seeing what Dutra could actually do, you know, tra, if you will, in another match. But Ricky Starks had to get over strong, and he did. Then he joins commentary. Sean Maluda and Alex Chamberlain versus Griff Garrison and Pillman Jr. I love Pillman Jr. in the ring. I just wish he wasn't such a goddamn idiot on social media. It was okay. Griff gets a pin. Cool. Whatever. Archer then attacks them all. He chokeslams Maluda onto Chamberlain, which was a pretty impressive move. And Jake Roberts says, "Why do I feel so good when you do things like that?" Thanks, Jake. I now have to go, you know, wash myself with a pressure washer. I don't care if it takes the skin off. It's going to be worth it because I feel so dirty after Jake Roberts said that. Archer then yells about Eddie. It's time to shut the hell up and fight. Okay. Max Caster and Anthony Bowens, who they just recently signed today. Max Caster has really good charisma and is good in the ring. Anthony Bowens has that chiseled look. He has that Jason Jordan-like look. And that, damn shame about Jason Jordan, in all honesty, regardless of what company you affiliate with, damn shame that he had to retire when he did. But Anthony Bowens really does have a great look. I can't wait to see what he does as a single. They took on Angel Fashion, who had blade-like contacts, and Aaron Solo. Caster wraps to the ring. Bowens has a very good look. Good pace to it. Certainly wasn't bad. Good tag work. This would have been just fine on Dynamite had Caster and Bowen's been signed and maybe they feature here's a new team and you do this could have fit in on Dynamite. and Assisted Cutter 1-2-3. VSK versus Allen Angels. Oh, the Dark Order's here. Allen Angels wins. VSK's fine. It's not that the Dark Order had bad athletes in the group. It's not that. I just don't give a shit about the group. And if they're just going to continue to do this, I'm not going to be interested. I'm sorry. You call me whatever. But I'm just not going to be interested. I'm not going to waste my time getting angry about it. I got angry with the whole thing they did with Brody Lee and destroying the Nightmare Family. The Dark Order destroying the Nightmare Family, which didn't help because Brody lost the championship in, 6 weeks? Peter Avalon is then looking for a new manager. He's doing the Christopher Walken SNL skit where he's facing the camera and trying to hit on a woman. That was about 15 to 20 years ago that they did that, by the way. And he got upset and he's calling himself Pretty Peter Avalon. I'm not saying Peter Avalon isn't a good talent, but this was shit. There's nothing wrong with trying new things, but this is a skit from 20 years ago. This was WWE-like, and I don't like saying that about AEW. Jersey Muscle versus Butcher Blade with the Bunny. Allie in those shorts. Good God, that's distracting. Her and Blade, they are such a happy couple, and God, he is so lucky. But in all seriousness, they should let Allie wrestle some more. One Jersey guy may have hurt his ankle. I hope he actually did. I hope he was just selling. I didn't catch their names. I'm sorry. Bomb Neckbreaker for 3. So Butcher and Blade naturally win. Natural Nightmares attack afterwards because they're feuding with Butcher and the Blade. D3 versus Will Hobbs. Well, D3 didn't get in all that much, so 78 kilos did not help him. Oklahoma Stampede, or just the Stampede, 1-2-3. I don't think he's actually from Oklahoma. If he is, then I apologize. Starks and Cage attack Hobbs, and then lights go out, and Darby apparently runs out and chases them out. Darby just flipped the light switch and said, okay, turn it back on now. Anyway. Uno and Grayson versus Baron Black and Nick Comoroto. Comoroto has a good look. Baron Black has a decent look. Actually, a pretty good look, in all honesty. Crown thing's a bit weird, but, you know, I'm not that familiar with his work. Uno and Grayson are not a bad working team. But the Dark Order, I don't care. Fatality for 3. Sean Dean and Cesar Bononi and Fuego del Sol versus Silver, 10, and Colt Cabana of the Dark Order. Boy, thanks. 3 matches with the Dark Order. It's like you specifically want me to not care about this episode. Like I'm the one fan they should be targeting. Sean Dean has talent. And, Silver gets the pin. He pins Del Sol. Cool. Lady Tapa versus Kylan King. Lady Tapa, who I've been impressed with for a number of years, hasn't wrestled in about 3 years. I think she was doing MMA stuff. I've tried to keep up on that stuff. That's a lot of wrestlers to keep up on. But been a fan of her since, you know, she appeared on Impact, and she appeared, I think, in one of the Mae Young Classics, if I recall correctly. I think it was Mae Young Classic 2, Electric Boogaloo. But she's good. She, you know, related to the Barbarian, and you could tell with the styles, like, she learned from him, and she moves pretty damn good. Kylan King I've been impressed with since her first appearance on Dark. I think she's got the talent. She's obviously green and needs to get better, but she's been able to show off a lot more. She's statuesque, she is beautiful, she has a striking look to her, and I think with some time, it'll be a couple years, she could have something, you know, she could really be a force to be reckoned with in AEW. They really need to sign her if they haven't. This wasn't a long match, it was strong, talented women, some hard hits. Kylan King with a frog splash, 1-2-3. Kylan King gained her first win. I'm pretty certain Kylan King will be, you know, they'll say Kylan King is all elite, you know, good. I'm not saying they need to sign 100 people. They don't need to go full on WCW, but sign enough people because they're going to need to phase some others out, some older ones out, to not be in-ring talents, and they need people to try and fill those spots. Even if they're never going to be legends, you need people to fill out the spots, and you need to phase some people out eventually. Chaos Project, which is Luther, who screams a lot, and Serpentigo, who has the streamers. Yeah, I don't think Serpentigo's a bad athlete at all, versus Private Party. And why is Luther wrestling? Why is Luther a thing? Why the stream? Not the streamers. He threw the streamers at Isaiah Cassidy and blinded him. He got blinded by the streamers. Gin and Juice for 3. I don't like Luther. I don't hate him as a person. I don't like him as a wrestler. Sammy Guevara versus Lee Johnson. Hey, good agility by both. And Sammy's a great heel, and Lee does some impressive dives as well. Sammy does, you know, a great goddamn dive at one point, and then pump knee strike, and then GTH, the, you know, go to Burning Hammer, basically. It's not actually what it's called, but not the Burning Hammer. You don't want to do that move. And then the Twist of Fate, because he's going to face off against Matt Hardy in the Elite Deletion match at Full Gear. Please go better than what happened at All Out. No crazy spots like that. So anyway, yeah, it was an episode of Dark. I will be ordering Full Gear. Will you guys? Let me know what you think in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, Twitter handle in the description. I'm John Rethlin. I'll see you soon.